With this video presentation, we would like to share the approach we adopted in a 66-year-old male patient referred to our center for an aortic root redissection and severe aortic regurgitation. For a type A acute aortic dissection, 1 year earlier and in our institution, the patient had undergone an ascending aorta and total arch replacement with zone 1 distal anastomosis and separate reimplantation of arch bursals. At that time, the patient presented in dramatic condition with shock due to aortic rupture and cardiac tamponade. Patient's serious comorbidities included moderate to severe COPD and chronic renal failure. Arch repair interventions with zone 0 or zone 1 distal anastomosis and arch vessels reimplantation with separate branches are increasingly performed. However, if on the one hand this technique both simplifies distal suturing and minimizes the risk of recurrent nerve injury, on the other, it complicates secondary root interventions due to encumbrance of the arch vessels branches in the mediastinum that make chest reopening, arterial cannulation, and aortic clamping more hazardous and problematic. This intervention was performed by Professors Marco Di Eusanio and Tristan Yan at the Cardiac Surgery Department in Ancona, Italy, in November 2017. Our risternotomy technique involves removal of the sternal wires and oscillating saw, patient's arterial pressure less than 100 mm of mercury, opening the pleural spaces, and tubing for prompt CPB institution ready on the operative table. In cardiac surgery in general, and in aortic surgery in particular, we believe excellent exposition is one important key to success. For this reason, all was done to dissect completely, free the heart, and all prosthesis with the arch vessels branches. After systemic heparinization, the left subclavian artery branch was cannulated through the interposition of an 8 mm Dacron graft. This allowed us to institute extracorporeal circulation and to guarantee an adequate and continuous cerebral and visceral perfusion. In fact, the very proximal offspring of the arch vessels branches hampered aortic clamping at access to the aortic root. Therefore, to place the aortic clamp in a more distal position, the decision was made to reroute the first branch, perfusing the right brain hemisphere, on second one, perfusing the left one. The anastomosis was performed with the heart beating and unilateral left brain perfusion at flow rate of about 1 liter per minute. So the clamp was placed and the root entered. The coronary ostia were exposed and the cardioplegic arrest was achieved by a retrograde and then anterograde infusion of costial cardioplegia. The Bentall procedure was then performed. The aortic root was extensively cleared from the surrounding tissue and the coronary buttons were prepared and fully mobilized for the following reattachment. This is the residual dissection of the aortic root. We'll be right back. The valve was accessed. And the annulus sized using a Perimount Magna sizer. Annular use stitches with the Teflon bridges were placed then on the aortic side. The proximal cuff of the Valsalva graft was trimmed down to 8 mm. The prosthetic valve was positioned inside of the Valsalva graft. The annular sutures were passed through the sewing ring of the prosthesis first and then through the folded proximal edge of the Valsalva graft. Once all the sutures were passed through, the valve and the graft were parachuted down onto the annulus. The sutures were tied and cut sequentially around the sewing cuff. This step completed the first proximal layer anastomosis. The second hemostatic layer was performed using a 4-0 polypropylene running suture, starting from the commissure between the left and the right annuli and progressing clockwise circumferentially. With the cautery, proper holes for the coronary buttons were created into the dacron graft. The coronary buttons were so re-implanted using a 6-0 polypropylene running suture. Finally, the graft was trimmed to an appropriate length and anastomosed to the old dacron prosthesis with a 4-0 polypropylene running suture. After the airing, coronary reperfusion was obtained and CBP waned off. This was the final result. The patient was extubated 10 hours later and uneventfully discharged 7 days after.